blessing ברחמים ומרא בימינו אמן. And that we all have this zechut to see and hear the messenger Eliyahu Nabi Eliyahu Nabi Zechu Latov. And we all have this zechut to see Beit HaMikdash HaShlishi Yain Dainu Bishuv Adonai Tzion.
Amen.
And we all have this zechut to go to Eretz Yisrael and to have a part in the land of Israel.
Amen.
And to go that on the wings of eagle.
Amen.
Amen. So okay, dear ladies, I would like to start reminding you all the cells to put on the closer to put on rotate and Besiyata Dishmaya. And Besiyata Dishmaya, we're going to start. I don't have a microphone, so please pay attention. So Baruch Hashem, we are in the month of Elul, and you remember that last lesson we spoke about the minhagim of the month of Elul, and one of them is tzedakah. To give tzedakah. And we said that tzedakah is there's even also a hint for the month of Elul. And it comes from Megillat Esther, and it's written, Mishloach manot, ish l'reu matanot l'agim, presents to give to poor people. And if you take the first letters of each word, ish is aleph, l'reu is lamed, vav is matanot, it starts with vav, elevionim to poor people, starts with lamed together, it's the month of Elul. So we are going to speak today, we had a few lessons about tzedakah. And we are going to speak about, this will be the conclusion of the perek of tzedakah b'siyata d'shmaya. It's written, we're going back to parashat Re'eh. This parasha of this week is Kitetze. Okay, so Hashem gave me lessons, and Be'ezrat Hashem, I hope that Racheli will put Be'ezrat Hashem the lessons, Be'ezrat Hashem, and you will see lessons about parashat Kitetze. You can go to Torah anytime. .com or rabbanitiris.com or the YouTube, there's lessons about Parashat Kitetze. So we're going back to Parashat Re, and we spoke, you remember Rosh Pina and everything, and Rabbi Meir Balanes, we had a few lessons about tzedakah. And over there we're going at Parashat Re, chapter 15, and it says, Ki yeh becha evyon, if there will be a poor person, me'echad me'achicha, one of your brothers, and we are all considered brothers and sisters, ve'echad sha'arecha, in one of your gates, one of your city, towns, בארצך, in your land, אשר השם אלוקיך נותן לך in Israel, לא תאמץ את לבבך, you shouldn't make your heart like a stone, you know, and close your fist, ולא תקפוץ את ידך and close your fist, מאחיך אביון, from your poor brother, כי פתוח תפתח את ידך לו, you should open your hand for him, ועבה תאביתנו די מחזורנו, you should give him as much as he needs, בעזרת השם, די מחסורה אשר יחסר לו. Okay, I want you to know three things. Tzedakah, charity brings peace. Brings peace among people. Makes people happy and bring peace. And it's written in Ishayah the prophet, chapter 32, verse 17. ויאמר עשה הצדקה שלום. The action itself of the tzedakah brings peace. Furthermore, it says that the geula b'siyata d'shmaya tzion b'mishpat tipade, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to make a pidyon for the children of Israel b'sareh b'tzedakah, which means Hashem is going to have a salvation for the children of Israel with tzedakah, b'tzedakah, you see, tzedakah shalom v'geula shalom, which means that Hashem is going to give us geula, Mashiach will come by the tzedakah that we do with each other. And tzedakah, I already told you in other lessons, it's not only the money, it's how we behave to Ahavat Chinam, unconditional love, is tzedakah, is charity. Matan beseter ichpeaf, when we give to people without them knowing who gave it to them, besiyata d'shmaya causes the anger of Hashem to go away and wakens the Kohanim. What Kohanim? Bruchim Abayim. Af, Michpe Af. Af, which means nose, Chotem. Because we take, when we get angry, we take the egg comes out of our nostrils. This, when we get angry, a person gets angry, the air comes out of his nostrils. So, when tzedakah, that people do not know who gave that tzedakah, causes Hashem not to be angry with us. And what is the initials of Af? It wakens the Kohanim that bring Korbanot in heaven. Aleph is Eliyahu Nabi. Eliyahu Nabi. And is Pinchas, Kohen Gadol. Both Kohanim, Ze'af, Matan, Besaderech Pe'af, which awakens the Kohanim. So we're going to start from the beginning. First I'm going to go to Shulchan Aruch. From Shulchan Aruch, Besiyata Dishmael, Yoredea, Chelek Daled, Tirchot Tzedakah. I tried Besiyata Dishmael, like to make a sikum, to sum up every, because it's a lot. So from the Rambam and from Shulchan Aruch, from Shulchan Aruch Yoredea, Tirchot Tzedakah, Siman Remez, and then from Zraim, Ilchot Matanot Le'Evyonim, from the Mishneh Torah LaRambam. So what you see over here is like to sum everything, v'mash benekudot. So dear ladies, let's start. It says, b'mshulchan aruch, yoredea, mitzvat ase. It's a mitzvah that you have to do. You know, there's mitzvot that you have to do, mitzvot that you are not allowed to do, or commandments that you are not allowed to do. מצוות עשה ליתן צדקה כפי השגת יד וכמה פעמים נצטפנו בה. Which means we have several times in the Torah we are commanded to give charity. וזה מצוות עשה. ויש לא תעשה, and you're going over the mitzvah of the commandments that it says that you לא תעשה, that you shouldn't be, by ignoring the mitzvah of צדקה. Why? Because תסתכלו, כי כתוב, לא תאמץ את לבבך, because it's written בתורה, פרשת ראה, it's written in the Torah, חומש דברים, פרשת ראה, it's written that you're not allowed to ignore, you make your heart like a stone to ignore people who need money, and you're not allowed to close your hand. So dear ladies, זה ממש כאילו מצוות עשה ואינב, if you ignore it, you go over, לא תעשה. לא תאמץ את לבבך ולא תקפוץ את ידך. וכל המעלים עיניו ממנה, and he who closes his eyes from the מצוות צדקה, ignores it, נקרא בליעל. It's called wicked. בליעל. וכאילו עובד אלילים, and like he worships other God. And you remember last lesson we were speaking? בסייעתא דשמיא about this, from חסד לאברהם, רבי אברהם, which is the grandfather of the חידה, זכותו תגן עלינו, and he says over there, that if Hashem says you have to give tzedakah, you're not allowed to close your hand, and you're not allowed to make your heart as a stone, not to give tzedakah. The evil inclination says, let them work, you're working, why should you give them the tzedakah? And you'll hear people that speak like this, why should I give them tzedakah? Let them work, and בסייעתא דשמיא, Hashem will give them tzedakah. He will give them the money. If you ignore poor people, dear ladies, because nobody knows the condition really of a person, and maybe he had work, and maybe they fired him, nobody really knows, and a person is ashamed to tell what's going on with him. So only the close people know exactly what's going on, but and the only one that really knows exactly is Hashem. Nobody else. Even the person himself doesn't really know all of the things that happens that caused him to come to this place. But b'siyata dishmaya, if you close your heart, it means that you're listening to the evil inclination. If you are listening to the evil inclination, you b'chas v'shalom, you make God and the evil inclination in the same level. Because you're not listening to God. God said, give charity. Don't close your hand. Don't close your heart. That's what God said. That's what Hashem said. But the evil inclination says, you work so hard. Why should you give it to others? So if you listen to him, it means yet that you're worshipping other gods. Chad mashmi, totally. And remember always, the first amount that you have in your head for tzedakah, this is the amount that you need to give. And I will give you an example. I wanted to give a tzedakah. And I wanted somebody to give in Israel instead of me, and I said, I'm going to give him from when somebody comes to Israel, I will give him to him. So I was writing an email. And I was writing an email and I was writing the amount. And then there was something that whispered to me, said, and if you won't have enough money, so maybe you should change it. You should give what exactly you have now, so shelo yeh chas v'shalom, that you don't have to give it. So I tried to. Listen, I tried to raise it. I tried to raise it, and while I'm trying to raise it, not only it wasn't erased, but other things were erased. And I said, that's from Hashem. This is the amount. And I left, and Hashem gave me to give them up. And I gave it now with my sister.
Wiping rose, the second felt is more than the first.
That's good.
The
mutar. That's the mutar. I'll give you from Shulchan Aruch. Okay, everything, you'll see. B'siyata d'ishmaya. So dear ladies, v'ketuv, and it's not only, but Shulchan Aruch says, b'yore de'at, that he who ignores charity is called Glial. V'ke'ilu oved elilim. Like he worship other gods. U'me'od yesh li'izaher b'ayin, to be very careful with this. Ki efshar she'abo li'shfichut damim. That he can cause shvichudat, which means that the poor person that didn't have and was shy to say anything, and the person didn't give him, at kedei kach she'amut ha'ani ha'mbakesh, that the poor person can die. And we have Nachum Ish Gamzu. You remember, I gave you the stories. Nachum Ish Gamzu was a very righteous rabbi. And one day he had two donkeys that he took, and his father-in-law gave him a schora. A merchant to take, and part of the merchant was cookies and things that he had, and that he had to bring to the market. On the way, there was a poor person who wanted from him a food, and he said, "Tell him, you know what? Wait till I have time to unload and to take and to give him." Until he unloaded, the poor person died. So shelo neda metzarot, he felt so bad, and he said, "Now the shvichud damim." The person died because you don't really know the condition of the person that comes to you. That's why today, you don't know, you can't go and make, you know, a shalom to write his name and everything and start searching and finding who's the person, who's not the person, something you have to give him. The person opens his hand, you have to give him something. So
anybody
that Hashem said, because Hashem is the one that pulls the strings. If somebody comes to you, it's from Hashem. It's not on his own he comes to you. And Hashem is just testing us with Jewish people and with non-Jewish people. Why? Because this is making peace with the nations. We are all the children of Hashem. We are the firstborns of Hashem. We have a merit that we have more parts of the neshama in us. But anybody that comes and opens, something to give, a food, something to put in the hand. So dear ladies, shelo neda, Nachum Ish Gamzu said to Hashem, because I wasn't quick to give him what he needed, he said, so Nachum Ish Gamzu said, Hashem, he said upon himself, Hashem, take my eyes that saw him and didn't have enough pity on him. And he said, because of that my legs didn't go fast, he says, he said upon himself to take, that Hashem will take his legs and his hands. And this is how Nachum Ish Gamzu was. He was without hands, without legs, couldn't see anything. He was on a bed, and his students, the scholars, put water and there are four legs to the bed. They put water so ants will not come on him, because then he can't move them out. And he said, it's better that I will do here than chas v'shalom in the libriyut, in the true world. So this is how shechas v'chalal again it is shvichud damim. Chas v'shalom, and shvichud damim also can be caused if we are starting to ask about this poor person in people, and publishing his name. This is also shvichud damim. This is also killing him. So dear ladies, marbe milim marbe chet. If we take a lot of words out of our mouth, the evil inclination will cause us chas v'shalom to sin. So less to speak and more to do. V'siyata d'ishmaya. And it says, kol amerachem al ha'anim, he who has pity on poor people, hakadosh baruch hu merachem alav. V'tistaklu hineh v'iten ha'adam elibo, that a person, a kadosh baruch hu, which means Hashem, has pity upon him. And a person should think and keep it in his heart, shehu mevakesh kol sha'a parnasato mehakadosh baruch hu, that we ask parnasa every hour from Hashem. All the time we ask, please give us good parnasa, that we won't need human beings. Ukmo shehu mevakesh hakadosh baruch hu ishma shavato, and like he asks from Hashem to listen to his cry for good parnasa, kach hu ishma shavat aniim. This is a way that Hashem tests him. That he says, you want me to listen to you? You listen to my children too. I gave you parnasa, give them from what I gave you. And Chovat HaLevavot, Rabbeinu Bechaye says about this. He says, where did I write it? Here. Habotech be'Hashem, and he who trusts Hashem, eino nish'an al hono, does not have his confidence on the money that Hashem gave him. Ve'hu be'enav kepikadon, and he knows that Hashem gave him only as a pikadon, to self-keep. And why? Shenitzavah ishtamesh bo ba'ofanim miyuchadim, that Hashem commanded him to use this money for the prosperity of his family and to give tzedakah from this. For all of his brothers and sisters, ad zman mugbal, in a limited time, because it's only a pikadon. Hashem gives you the money; it's a test in this world, but it's not yours. It's Hashem's money. Lia kesev azav, the prophet Haggai writes. Hashem says, "It's my money; it's not yours. The gold, the money, everything is mine. Silver, gold, platinum, all of the jewelry, everything is mine." Hashem says, "I'm just giving you a pikadon." Pikadon, which means that I give it to you now for your fixing in this world, but when you go out, I take it back and give it to somebody else. The money, the house, the clothing, the cars, everything. Nothing goes with us. It's only an imaginary world, this world, but it's a big world, because only here we can do the mitzvot, the commandments. So we are mezakim, have a merit for ourselves, our children, Klal Yisrael, the whole world, and also all of the souls that went out of this world. They cannot be mezakeh themselves. They need us, because we are in the world of Asiyah, of action. That's the only world. This is a big world. Even though it's the lowest world, it's the biggest world. Because only here you can do the commandments. Only here you can make a house for Hashem. Here, batachtonim, in this world. And bring the Shekhinah, the divine presence among us. Only here you can be mazake, giving a merit to all of the souls that went out of this world, only in this world. Mm-hmm. So dear ladies, let's continue. It says furthermore, lo'olam ein adam ma'ani min hatzdakah. You will never see a person that gave tzedakah and became poor. Never. Ve'lo davar ra ve'lo ezek mitgalgel al yada. And nothing bad and nothing can be caused because of this. Like it says, because it only brings peace around me. It's more deep. It brings peace around the elements that the person is also built of. It's fire, water, air, and earth. So all the four elements are in peace. Now, dear ladies, it says like this. Okay, I'll continue over here in a few minutes. I want to give you the degrees of tzedakah. There are 8 degrees. Shulchan Aruch and the Rambam says 8 degrees of tzedakah. And what are the degrees of tzedakah? The highest degree, the first one is the highest degree. Hamachzik beyad Yisrael she'ein lo ma'od del machzoro v'chzakta bo b'chaimach. He who gives a poor person either money, or he gives to help him, or he gives him b'siyat lishma alone, or furthermore, which is the biggest thing, teaches him a profession. Okay. Yeah, teaches him a profession, b'siyata d'shmeh, that he can, after that he doesn't need other people, he can provide for himself. So, dear ladies, v'chzakta bo v'chaimach. Zot omeret, you help him, and then he will have the ability, b'siyata d'shmeh, to provide by Hashem for himself, and he doesn't need for the charity from people. This is the highest level. The second level, hanotem tzedaka la'aniim, ואינו יודע למי נותן, וגם המקבל אינו יודע למי מקבל. The second level, dear ladies, and this level saves you from a weird death. Death of fire, death from animals, weird death. ממש כתוב במסכת בבא בתרא. Which means that you give the charity to גבאים, to גבאי צדקה from the shul, you don't know whom they're going to give them, and they don't know from whom they got it. This is the second level of tzedakah. Okay, so which means you give, you don't know to whom you're giving, and they're getting, and they don't know from whom they're getting. This is the second level. The first, but the highest level is giving a profession, giving a loan that he will stand on his own feet, and he doesn't need everything, because that he won't have any shame to provide for his family. Like he looks at his wife and his children and won't feel shameful. That's a big thing. That's called Ahavat Yisrael. when you really, because the way that you want to be treated, you treat others. So the third level, which is a lower level, Hanoten, Yodea Lemi Unoten, he who gives knows to whom he gives, Vamekabel Eno Yodea Mi Mekabel, but the one that received doesn't know from whom he gets. But the one that gave knows to whom he's giving. But the one that gets doesn't know. You know, and the fourth one, at a lower level, Hanoten Eno Yodea Mi Mekabel, the one who gives doesn't know that doesn't know to whom he gives, but mekabel yodea memi mekabel. Katati anoten eno yodea lemi noten. Okay, I'm mixed it over here, that the one that gives, besiata lishma, he doesn't know to whom he gives, but the one who gets knows from whom he gets. This is what our sages used to do. They were poor people next to the synagogue. They used to take money, put them in nylon bags or, you know, in a small package and just throw it back. So they didn't know who gets. The poor people won't feel ashamed. Vesiata dishmaya. And they don't know. The one that gives doesn't know who gets it. So the merchan noten vesiata dishmaya no yodea lemi va mekabel yodea lemi mekabel. The fifth level, shiten la'ani beyado lifnei shivakesh tzedakah. The fifth level is that he will give a poor person the charity, because he knows that he needs it, before the poor person asks for tzedakah, opens his hands for tzedakah. This also completes the name of Hashem, because you remember that I told you tzedakah is the name of Hashem, we have it in our hands, because the yud is the fourth to give tzedakah, this is the yud. Now the hey is the hand, five fingers, so if I'm giving the tzedakah, I have yud, but I have the letter hey. And then when I give, before he put his hand out, then he opens his hands to receive it, I have another hey, and the zroa is vav. You see, I have a vav, hey, and another hey, yud kei vav kei. But if the poor person opens his hand before I gave him, he asks already from me, the name of Hashem is from the end to the beginning. Exactly the opposite.
Hey, vav.
Yeah, you're not allowed to say. Okay, but exactly the opposite. So, dear ladies, the next level, we had a whole lesson about this, and I'm just reminding you, I don't want to get into it now. The next level, number six, Shiten la'ani la'achar shezei bakesh me'ado. This is that poor people already opens his hands and asks for the tzedakah. The next, the seventh level, which is a lower level, שנותן לו פחות ממה שזקוק, אבל עושה בסבר פנים יפות. The next level, that he gives him less than he needs, because he doesn't have more than that to give him, but he speaks to him and comforts him and gives him with a smile and makes him happy and strengthens his confidence in Hashem. This is the seventh level. The eighth level, שייתן לו בעצה, that he gives it tzedakah because he knows he has to keep, but he doesn't want to give. And then הוא מוציא ממונו, and he become על כן, he gives it בעצב, in sadness, שהוא מוציא ממונו לאחרים. That he gives it in sadness, that he, בסייעתא דשמיא, gives his money, the money that Hashem gave him, to others. This is the lowest level. He still gives, but he gives it with a very heavy heart. So dear ladies, let's continue to another level. So these are the eight, Besiyata Dishmaya, eight ma'alot, degrees of tzedakah that is written in Beshulchan Aruch Barambam, Biyure Deah Barambam, and Bezraim. And I would like to tell you the highest level of mitzvah, it's mitzvah gdoah me'al hakol l'seyel et talmidei chachamim aniyim. To give scholars in Torah, yes. Bachurim, scholars in Torah, b'siyata dishmaya, that learn Torah, that learn, really, truly learn Torah, that don't have money to give them, because anything that you give them, you have half of the Torah studies. Half of it. Yesh sachar. Like zvulun b'sachar. Half of it is b'ezrat Hashem, yours and your children. Once you give for a kol el, a place that they study Torah, this is a big, big mitzvah. B'ezrat Hashem, achzik talmidei chachamim. Now, by this pasuk, all of this is learned from this pasuk from Parashat Re'eh. By this pasuk, there's kdimuyot. Well, if a few poor people come to me, who do I give the tzedakah first? For whom do I give the tzedakah? So now we're going again to look at this pasuk, to look how beautiful it is. Everything comes from this, Parashat Re'eh. And let's look together. First of all, we see Ebyon, Ki Ebechai Ebyon. If you have a poor person, this is the first one, over here, Ebyon. You see, a poor person. So what is, if I have a, three poor persons, one of them needs food, one of them needs clothing, one of them needs furniture. Achatam and Kala, they need furniture for their home. Whom do I give first?
Food.
So, first of all is food, then clothing, and then furniture or other things, okay? Why? First, achetet ha-nefesh, that he won't die. You remember, the shvichut damin. So first, that the, give him livelihood. So first is mazon. If I don't have money, I have only to help one of them. So the one that doesn't have food, this is the first one. We give food. Then clothing, the second. And the third one is if they don't have furniture or things in the house, this is the third one. The second thing is mechad achecha, one of your brothers. And all Klal Yisrael is called brothers. But let's say it's one of your relatives, siblings, b'siyata d'shmaya, who comes first? So, and don't forget that also a friend is considered like a relative. So it starts, b'siyata, it's very important, all of these things. The first thing is the parents. First is your parents. Yes, to provide for your parents. This is a karat hatov, gratefulness, that they provided for you, first is your parents. Never ignore them. Whatever you can, help them. First, I wrote it 1, 2, 3. You know, I tried to make like a, I told you, like a mathematical equations that it will have it so you can remember and see. Second is your sons. Third is your brothers and sisters. So it goes first parents, children, brothers and sisters, then uncles, and then cousins, niece and cousins. Okay? And don't forget that a friend, a good friend, is also considered b'siyata d'shmaya, a relative. Next step, b'siyata d'shmaya, this is the second step, mechad b'achecha. This is number two. Number three, b'echad sha'arecha. Number three is b'echad sha'arecha. Okay, this means in your town, in your city. So, aniye ircha kodmim l'aniye ir acheret. The poor person that are in your town, in your city, come before poor persons that are out of town. All of this is from Shulchan Aruch. Again, I'm maskira lachem. Meyore dea, ilchot tzedakah, and from Matanot Levyonim, Mizraim, and Mishneh Torah LaRambam. Okay, it's the part 6, Mishneh Torah LaRambam. All of this. So it's, aniyei ircha kodmim la'aniyei ir acheret. The fourth thing is ba'artzecha. Ba'artzecha sh'ashem elokecha noten lach. This is the fourth. In the land that Hashem gave you. Which land Hashem gave us? The land of Israel. So, aniye eretz Yisrael kodmim la'aniye chutz la'aretz. That the poor people, that's we are just doing this. We are gathering, and Bezrat Hashem, what we have, we'll give also to other people here. Oh, Aniyei Eretz Yisrael kodmim la'aniyei chul. This is the third. No, בדרגות, הדרגה הכי זה פה. אחר כך זה השנייה, זה השלישי, זה אחד השני.
So if we live in Galut, we live here. Yes. Now where is more important to give tzedakah? Our town or send it to Israel?
Okay. Of course, the people that are in your town, and you give us amount for the people in Israel. That's right. What we are doing. That's what I'm gathering from you now, בבית אברהם, בעזרת השם ולכולם. אז בסייעתא דשמיא, we are giving to, and you have to give to the people who live in your town. So, this is the fourth thing, בארצך אשר השם אלוקיך נותן לך. Now, dear ladies, there are two kinds of poor people. One is a really poor person that doesn't have anything, and the second one is a rich person that lost everything and became poor. What do you do with a rich person that lost everything and became poor? So you have to know that you have this katuf. It's written in this pasuk. It's the clue. Ba'avet ha'avitenu day machsoro asher yechsar lo. Which means that you have to give him and to help him contain his lifestyle. A rich person. At the beginning, because for him it's a big shock. You see, a poor person that doesn't have, when we are in a level of middle class or lower, we already are used to these things. But when you are in the high class, social class, when you fall, it's like the whole world was ruined for you. You don't know how to cope with this, and this is also shfichud damim. You can, chas v'shalom, make a suicide or something to yourself. It's considered also shfichud damim. So you have to help him to contain at the beginning his lifestyle until he understands, and to help him to be more modest in the way he lives. When he learns how to be, he has the tools how to be more modest, to adjust to a more modest lifestyle, b'siyata d'shmaya. So you also learn it from this person. Now, dear ladies, what happens with yeshiva? Because I told him it's a big thing to give to kollel and yeshivot. So also with this, we have three levels. The first level, Chava. The first level is called Kirva Ishit. Kirva Ishit means, there are three levels in yeshiva. Kirva Ishit, Kirva Ayonit, and Kirvat Makom. You want to give charity, you want to give tzedakah to B'siyata D'shmaya, to yeshiva. So to whom do you give? So the first level is Kirva Ishit, to the yeshiva that you learned and studied. Of course you have a kind of gratefulness, you need to give them. And especially when you know that your parents didn't pay the whole tuition. So you can, even if you're now living, you have a good parnasa, good income, Bezrat Hashem, then B'siyata D'shmaya, this is very important, then you can make even a calculation how much your parents didn't pay, and you can pay all that was missing, so they can help other students, other Jewish people that will go and study in the yeshiva. So first, Kirva Ishit, where you study. You studied, your children studied, your brothers and sisters, to give them tzedakah. The second one is Kirva Ayonit, which means, what is Kirva Ayonit? It means that B'siyata D'shmaya, like you are from Breslev, so you will think to give yeshivot of Breslev. You are Kippah Sruga, so you'll give Kippah Sruga, Bnei Akiva. You are Satmer, so you'll give first yeshivot of Satmer. This is Kirva, it's the same idea, the same thinking. So it's nothing pasul beze. Everything is legitimate. So you give Kirva Ayonit. This is the second level. The third level is called Kirvat Makom, which means, now you have the yeshivot in your city that you want to send your children. Like if you have Yeshiva University, you have Litvish Yeshivot, all of the yeshivot that are the same as you, B'siyata D'shmaya, the same as your. How do you say it in English?
Point of view.
Same level. Same standard.
It's the same way that you keep the Torah, but everybody needs to keep the Torah the same way, but they have the same inagim, the same ideas, Bezrat Hashem. So, if you have in your city and in this next city, and both of them are sending you to donate for them, first of all, Kirvat Makom. The ones that are in your city, for them you donate first. Okay, so remember, regarding yeshivot, we have, first of all, Kirva Ishit, where we studied, in what yeshiva we studied. The second thing is Kirva Ayonit, that the same derech, the same thinking we have with that yeshiva. And the third thing, the place that you live in. So you first give to the yeshivot in the place that you live. If you have the same Kirva Ayonit with yeshivot outside the city and inside the city. This is the third thing to see at Rishmaya. I want you to know, it's written that Shkula Tzedakah Keneged Kol HaMitzvot. That Tzedakah is parallel to all of the mitzvot. Furthermore, in chapter 112 in Tehillim, David HaMelech says this, B'siyata D'shmaya, look what he says about the mitzvah of Tzedakah. He says, טוב איש חונן ומלווה יחלקל דבריו במשפט כי לעולם לא ימות. לזכר העולם יהיה צדיק. Which means a person who gives tzedakah, Hashem doesn't give him to fall. Forever he is a tzaddik. Mishmual ra'a lo ira. He will be, just like Shulchan Aruch says, that he who gives tzedakah, he shouldn't be afraid of anything, because the tzedakah saves from death. Why does tzedakah save from death? Because if you give life to a person, Hashem measures for you exactly what you measured for another person. You measured in the way that a person measures for others, Hashem measures for him. So if you measured life for another person, you gave him and gave him livelihood, Hashem gives you back livelihood. So ממש מידה כנגד מידה בנות יקרות. And he said, פיזר נתן לאביונים צדקתו עומדת לעד. If you opened your hand and you gave charity to poor people, your righteousness stays forever. צדקתו עומדת לעד קרנות תרום בכבוד. רשע יראה בך שיניו יחרוק בנמס, תאוות רשעים תאבד. So dear ladies, the ones that are wicked people that don't want to open their hands and say, don't let them work, why should I give them the money? In which mean, even they don't come to this level. Shaitan, that they give sadly to somebody because they worked on their money, they don't really want to give, but sadly they give. There are people that even for this level, they don't come to this level. So dear ladies, it's הנותן צדקה מדבק במידתו של הקדוש ברוך הוא. Who we give צדקה? Is like b'siyata d'ishmaya, it clings to the midah, to the attribute of Hashem, which means Hashem gives livelihood to people. By giving tzedakah, you give livelihood to people, which means you bring the geula closer. You cause Mashiach to be here closer. Amen. Now, dear ladies, let's continue. So, we are going to Maaser, b'siyata d'ishmaya. And where did I write the pasuk? I didn't write the pasuk. Well, I'll give you the pasuk, the siyata d'ishmaya, we'll get to Maaser. So, the tzedakah was called Maaser. You have to give 10th of what you earn. So, dear ladies, Omer Shulchan Aruch, who gives 10th? All of the ones that are, you know, in the middle circle, middle class. All the ones that are middle class, not rich, not poor, they give middle class. Benoni, I'm writing. Benoni, Maaser. 10%. From what do you give Maaser? From the gross?
Gross. Not the net, the gross.
Okay, so what do you give the first year from the gross? If you have a
gross?
If you have a no,
from the profit, made, from the profit, or okay, from the entire sale,
netto be brutto.
No,
brutto is gross.
Okay,
gross. Okay, yes. So, but the first year you give from the gross, and the second year and on you give from the net. Now the question is, do you give after you take off the mortgage, the electricity? No. You don't take off the mortgage and the electricity and everything, but you give net from what you have net, without giving this, you don't take this out from in calculation from the net, and then you give from that maaser. You give from the whole net that you have.
But taxes.
Ma?
Taxes.
Ken.
So, taxes.
Dear ladies.
After taxes?
Ma? Let's say there is a paycheck.
Wait, I'll go into it. Okay. Okay. First, I'll just want to give the introduction. So first, the Benoni noter maaser. Ani patur mimaser. A poor person that cannot provide for his family, b'siyata d'ishmaya patur, he doesn't have to give maaser, because first he has to give the livelihood to his family. But it's always good to give a small amount of tzedakah. Every poor person has to give tzedakah, even a person who knocks on the door and asks for charity has to give tzedakah. The rich people should give chamishit, which means 20%. 20%. And if they can, more. Usually it says, Chazal say, the sages say, don't give more than 20%. But when are you allowed to give more? Shulchan Aruch says, on the bed of death, lo aleinu, then you should give as much as you can charity. Because you never know if your children will give after you, for yourself. So you should always be sure that you give charity. Nachon Yoliv, King Solomon says it beautifully. Well, you work very hard, you have a lot of, you know, palaces and everything, but you never know when you pass from this world what your children are going to do with this. Maybe they lose everything. Maybe they will close their hands and they won't give charity in your name. So, and they won't help you to elevate your soul in the true world.
As soon as you can.
So dear ladies, this is a very, very, very important thing, and it's very important, mamash, to calculate 10%. Mamash, to calculate. Now, before we go to questions and things, because I'm going to give you questions, Bezat Hashem, and answers. Katuv aso te'aser bishvil chetit asher. I think I wrote it, but I don't know where I wrote it.
The last pasuk over there.
יש לך את ה... יש לך את הזהב
כסף? I remember that I wrote, but I didn't know where I wrote it. Okay, I had a very full day today. It's a miracle that I'm giving you a lesson בכלל. It's a ממש מהשם. So look, כתוב, אסור תעשר. And it says in מלאכי. And there's a big argument about מעשר. If maaser ksafim, a maaser of money, Be'ezrat Hashem, if this is what the what Hashem meant when he said that asor te'aser bishvil chetit asher, try me by this, because he says in Malachi, try me by this. But then he says, if you give a tenth of the wheat, the grains, and the wine, and everything, mamash things that you get from earth. So some of the sages say, Arama says, yes, you're allowed to try Hashem, because this is what he meant also, maaser ksafim. To give a maaser, the tenth of money that you earn, not only what you get from your field. So, and the Shila says no, and there's a big conversation between the sages, but in general, all say it's also Kiddushem Shamayim, that a person who gives a tenth, exactly a tenth, Bezrat Hashem, Hashem will make him rich with them, because then you see that the more you give, the more Hashem gives you. So, what is Taaser? Look how beautiful, it opens your luck. How do we know that? We go asor te'aser, which means you have to give a tenth. So te'aser, give a tenth. I'm writing it te'aser like this. Give a tenth. Okay, it's the action of giving te'aser. Taf in numerical value is 400, ayin is 70, shin is 300, and resh is 200. I'm going to take 10% of each one of them. 10% of 400 is
40.
10% of 70?
7.
10% of 300 is 30. 10% of 200 is 20. Now we go back to numerical values. 40 is the letter Mem. 7 is the letter Zayin. 30 is the letter Lamed. And 20 is the letter Chav. Mazal Chav, your luck. You see, you open your luck when you give it
to me. Where did you find this?
Again, I'm telling you. No, it's only the sponsor Chava Claus.
Where did you find it?
Should you make it for yourself? No, it's from Rabbi Glazelson. So, Zeta Ha'asel, dear ladies. You take 10, Besiata Nishimaya, 10.
It's a Shabbat Tmuna.
10.
It's
a Nire.
I'm joking.
I really try, Hashem will help me, because I really try to remember, to make everything that I can give you in one lesson, everything together, pachot yoter. So again, taf, ta'aser, the action of taking a tenth is ta'aser in Hebrew. Taf in numerical value is 400. Ayin is 70. Yeah, I'm explaining again. Ayin is 70, shin is 300, and resh is 200. Let's take tenth of each one of them. 10th of 400 is 40, 10th of 70 is 7, 10th of 300 is 30, 10th of 200 is 20. Let's go back to numerical value. What is the letter that equals 40 is the letter Mem. The letter that equals 7 is the letter Zayin. The letter that equals 30 is the letter Lamed. The letter that equals 20 is the letter Chav. Together it's Mazal Chai, your luck. So once you give a 10th, and give don't 10. Be afraid. Give Hashem 10. Says, try me by 10. This in the prophet Malachi, in the book of Malachi, he says, try me by this.
10%.
Yeah. So don't be afraid to give a 10th. And you remember, rich people give 20%. And if there's pikuach nefesh, like a person is in a situation that you have to give more than that, they should give more than that. Middle class, 10%. And poor people don't need to give maaser, but they need to give charity. Okay? Everybody needs to give charity. It's a commandment from the Torah.
It's easy to poor people to give 10%. They're gonna
give. I know. Okay.
Usually the poor people, they want
to
give,
but
they don't have. The rich people, they have, they don't want to give. הרבנית, יש לך את הפורמולה של הזהב, כסף?
Oh, כן, כן. אבל לא יכנס, תביאו לי קודם. עשיתי לכם את זה. I gave you a lesson.
I know.
כן, זה הנותן בריא. נתתי לכם את זה.
I know.
אבל
זה כל כך מתאים עכשיו, זה הצול.
בנות, אוקיי. What money? Let's... It's organized. I want to give you the questions and the answers. Please. Don't forget that I don't have a microphone. Okay, so there was a place that people asked, and I asked also Rabbi Gamliel, Aryeh Gamliel, several questions, and I want to give you the answers. Do we give maaser only from the money that we earn? It's very important questions. Only from the money that we earn, or also from gifts? So, dear ladies, we need to give from the money that we earn, from the net, after the first year. If you open the business, from after the first year, we give from the net. We need to give from the money that we earn, b'siyata d'shmaya. And dear ladies, and all of the money that we got, grants. If we got grants, you know, you get grant, or sometimes companies give you. From this, you also need to give money.
That's a gift, yeah?
Yes. It's a gift, but you got a grant from this also, you need to calculate my service.
If the parents give money also?
Okay. Let me answer all the questions that I should be able to prepare here, and then if you have another question, ask me, because I have a lot of questions over here. The second thing, if a person is getting married and he got money for his wedding, does he need to give myself?